Welcome back, Phosphor Dot fans. Earl at thelogbook.com. Still surviving Mars, still wondering why no one at all is bothering to build the excavator. This is a what the game calls a wonder technology. And a meteor's incoming. Oh, there's some resources there. Maybe someone should go get those resources before they get meteored any further. Okay, the meteor storm is happening up here. Good place for it. Good place for it. It has my permission to happen up there. Maybe this was not a good place to bring one of my rovers. But the good thing is anomalies are appearing, and that means the scientific rovers, the exploration rovers, are on their way to scan these anomalies, which will probably help out our research quite a bit. Always a good thing, in my opinion. So, and here comes the other one. Got quite a haul. Oh, is that naturally occurring polymers? I believe it is. Which sometimes meteors do leave. Oh, that's one of the resource rovers. Well, hey, buddy, there's some stuff over here, too. Oh, no, that's not stuff. Okay. No, wait a minute. Wait a minute, pal. There's all sorts of stuff up here. Come back. Left over from dredgers, and no one has... no one has retrieved them. Okay. The green penguin... is still being unloaded. Anomaly found. Okay. Here come more resources. Maybe everyone can get excited about this. 5 anomalies. Wow.
Colonists are departing.
Really? No. Come back over
anomaly
here.
Analyzed.
All right. We've analyzed an anomaly. So many resources. The problem with the automated resource gathering is that it goes and gets one thing, and it's like, oh, I've got my one thing. Now I'm going back to base with it. It's like, no, get all the things, dude. So much meteor down there than it is here. And that's a good thing.
Anomaly analyzed.
Okay, apparently I need to build a new storage depot for machine parts. I was kind of hoping maybe you guys would like take them all up and build the excavator. Which would be a cool thing to be doing. Maybe if I park one of my RC commanders there, it will be like, oh, hey, we could be building the excavator. Yes! Yes, thank you. Thank you. All right. Let's send one of these rockets back. Maybe both of them. We have some Earth-sick colonists, so Let's get these shiny, unhappy people out of here. Hey, the excavator is finally getting built. No idea how happy that makes me.
Anomaly analyzed.
All right. Where are you going, my friend? Are you going to... All right, I'm taking you out of automated mode, and I am going to have you take some concrete over there so we can build the excavator. See how frustrated I am about this? I just want to build the excavator. Is that so wrong? Now, I'm going to have it unload that concrete.
Anomaly analyzed.
In the designated spots. Boy, I bet this is doing wonders for our research. Of course, outsourcing research would also do wonders for our research. All right, offload some more concrete. Now, hang on. I'm not done with you yet. I'm not done with you people yet. Going to have it start bringing in the machine parts. The whole reason I had two rockets of machine parts brought to Earth was to, wait for it, build the excavator. I just want to build the excavator. Can I get it done in this session of the game? Let's find out. Let's see if we can get this thing built before the end of this video. Oh, good. Oh, good. It's finally happening. Let me see. I'm gonna go. I am taking manual control of both the resource rovers to just bring machine parts up there to build the excavator. You know what? I don't think any more dredgers are coming, despite that marker still being there for a future dredger landing site. I think it's time to bring this other rover up here. And why? So it can help build the excavator. Maybe it will get built faster if I put some machine part storage right there and load it up. That seems like it was probably a solid plan. Okay, now they're really building the excavator. Happy day. We are down to 41 units of concrete. We need fewer than that to build the excavator. And man, look at them go. They emptied that thing. Look at that one guy. It's like something out of I Love Lucy. He's just... Yeah, I'm building it right here, buddy. Yes. All right. Where is this other concrete that we supposedly have? Because it's not there. It's up there. Okay, so I'm going to go retrieve that and keep hauling over machine parts. We're probably going to need another rocket load of machine parts by the time this is all over with, just to compensate for all the machine parts we just used. Or actually, hang on. No, that was all the machine parts we needed right there. I will take some back, but I'm also going to leave some. There wasn't a lot of concrete over there. Okay, put all the machine parts back. All right, I think it's time to bring some more stuff from Earth. We're actually going to have to bring concrete from Earth, and that's heavy. It's not expensive, but it is heavy, so a rocket will only hold 60 units of it. I'm gonna go steal some concrete from over here. It is being produced here by the waste rock processing plant, but I just want to build the excavator. Let's get whatever concrete they put on that pad. Oh, hey, there's some more concrete. All right, my friend, thank you for your service.
Dust storm approaching.
A dust storm. Oh, awesome. Just as I have a rocket coming in with much needed supplies. Okay, now that we have researched the mohole, let's see what it will take to build that. 400 concrete, 100 metal, 300 machine parts. Okay, so obviously we are going to have to let the excavator, which I am in the process of trying to build, do its thing for a while before we can attempt construction of the mohole. But oh, when we do, so many of our resource woes are over. We have all the concrete we need. We have all the machine parts. It's all metal, baby. We're almost there. We're almost there. I am excite, as the kids say. I will bring more metal over here if it will help, and have a feeling it may be necessary before it's all over with. Can we build it? Yes, we can. Okay, here comes the extra concrete, which we may or may not need, but it makes me feel better to have it on hand, just in case something needs repair. Oh good, tourists are departing. Great. So, alright. Killing multiple birds with a single projectile, that's always good. We're so close to this thing being built. Let me get this fella out of the way. All right. It's happening. It's happening. I want y'all to see this. They don't call it a wonder for nothing. They call it that because it's part of the game. Send that rocket home.
There are Earthsick colonists.
You guys are about to see a wonder. Here it comes. Here it comes. Made it happen in this video. Awesome. I just wanted to build the excavator. That's all. Is that so wrong? They look like we're not worthy. And there we go. There we go. We constructed a wonder. Oh, got a bunch of research points. Hey, and that gets us the automated storage. And you know what we need right now? We need to go ahead and set up automated storage for concrete right here on site, right next to it. Because we are about to be swimming in concrete. Okay. This is exciting. This is exciting. All right, we cut through a lot of research stuff there. Let's put microfusion on the research list. That is the artificial sun. Now look at this. 200 concrete, 300 metal, 300 polymers. And it consumes a gigantic amount of water when you start it up. But this thing solves your power woes. I'm not saying all of our troubles are over in this game, but we are about to have fewer troubles than we were having before. I am digging it. All right, now we're working on the safe mode technology. What is this? Xeno extraction. Water extractor, concrete extractor, metals extractor, and rare metals extractor gain 50% bonus production. Oh, yes. Thank you. Please and thank you. We're going to prioritize that. We've got a dust storm coming in, and I'm cool with it. You know why, my friends? Because we have the extractor. Cue the maniacal laughter.